My name is Stephen Lewis, and I'm going to be staging an exhibit at the Quincy Library for the month of March, and the topic is Women's Struggle for Equality. March 8th is recognized as International Women's Day, and it has been for many years now, and it was officially recognized by the United Nations many years ago. I've been collecting for the past 14 years or so posters, labor union posters, and posters that reflect progressive political issues. So I now have a collection of about 4,000 posters from around the world. And one of those issues has been Women's Struggle for Equality and International Women's Day. I come out of a union that I was active in for many years that's made up of 70% women. So these posters mean a lot to me in terms of my life and being involved in the struggle for women's equality. The particular poster you reference about women in the building trades is made of women. It pictures women from Massachusetts who were some of the pioneers in working at the various building trades, which for those who might not know what that term means, it means some of the skilled trades like plumbing, pipe fitting, carpentry, ironwork, things like that. There's actually a couple of posters that I really like in Dutch from labor unions in the Netherlands. And one of them depicts a woman with a shaved head and a beard. And the other has a woman with a mustache. And both of them sort of reflect the idea of what women have to go through to get equal treatment and being hired on jobs. Similar type of theme, that of course is an American poster. And the idea is that, this poster goes back, it's a number of years old, but it goes back to when women were having a very difficult time getting involved in various types of jobs, building trades being one of them, where women are much more accepted today. There continues to be some occupations that it is hard for women to break into. Unlike many years ago, women now make up a lot of workers, certainly in some unions, not all unions, but in some unions. My union, for example, which is SEIU 509, Local 509, has about 12,000 members, and probably about 75% of them are women. One of the posters in the exhibit is from Greece. It was sort of an interesting story about how I came by that. I had gone to an office, a trade union office, because I knew that they had some posters there. They were expecting me, and I got those posters. And this woman said, "Oh, I have a friend who works at the Young Women's Christian Association. This is in Athens." And she said, "Let me give her a call and see if she's got any posters there." So she made the call, and the answer was yes. And so I walked across to Athens, and sure enough, this woman gave me this beautiful poster about women. That's actually a very old poster depicting women marching with sort of mops and cleaning tools. And in the caption with the poster, it talks about the struggle for bread, which is very interesting because last year was the centennial of the Bread and Roses strike up in Lawrence, Massachusetts. What happened was in 1912 there were a lot of factories in Lawrence, and a lot of the workers there were young women, immigrant women, and they were paid very low wages, worked long hours, and so finally in the year of 1912 they walked out en masse from these factories into the streets on strike, demanding better wages and more time off, and hence the term bread reflecting wages and roses reflecting more time off. At the time, the National Guard, the police were called out, the National Guard was called out. One person died in the struggle, but the women eventually returned to work and they did get a raise and reduced number of hours. And so last year there were a lot of events up in Lawrence sort of commemorating the 100th anniversary of that. I'm hoping maybe some artists or art students will be inspired by the type of advocacy art that's reflected in the posters, that some people who just like art, there are some very creative graphic art in the posters. Other people, I hope, will get inspired by some of the ideas or will get them thinking about some of these ideas, about why women have been denied jobs, about why domestic violence is so prevalent, why in a number of countries women are not treated as equal citizens, denied the right to drive, the right to vote, things like that.